What's up, fam? I'm sure you guys saw the thumbnail and read the title of today's video. And just a reminder, if you like this type of content, hit the like button and subscribe. Without further ado, let's get on to the stuff. So today we're going to be talking about how to MIDI your Moog Subharmonicon. I've seen a lot of videos where they just kind of talk about how to sync it to the clock. Not really much else, but I wanted to go over how you would control that with a external sequencer. So for this example, I have the Electron Digitone, and the only thing besides a sequencer that you're going to need for this is obviously the supplied MIDI 3.5-inch cable dongle thing for your Subharmonicon, and a MIDI cable to attach to some kind of a sequencer, be it a DAW or, in this case, the Electron Digitone. So to start with, what you're going to need to do is set the appropriate MIDI channel. When the Subharmonicon comes shipped, it is set at MIDI channel 1, and without digging into the system exclusive files, which is pretty heady, I don't recommend doing that. Just leave it set at 1. So whatever device that you're using, you're going to want that to send on MIDI channel 1. For the Electron, you go into MIDI, Syn 2, and set the channel there. For the Digitone, I had to set up the synth tracks 1 through 4 on MIDI channels 5 through 8, and then MIDI channels as 1 through 4 so that this project would work. That being said, the only thing that you really have to do, other than set the appropriate MIDI channel to get anything to be read, is set the appropriate MIDI controller change numbers. What's really cool about the Subharmonicon is that you've got 6 notes, and with MIDI, each one of those notes can be controlled with the MIDI. In addition to both of the envelope generators, filter, and one for the amplifier, you can control both the attack and decay via MIDI. You can also control the play, start and stop, but to set the MIDI CC for that, you have to, again, dig into the system exclusive, and that's kind of a pain in the butt. You also have access via MIDI to the rhythm generator logic, which affects how the clock outputs, the clock output here. Basically, anytime it sees an or, it'll advance the clock, or if it sees an XOR, depending on the value of whatever. So that's just something to keep in mind if you use Eurorack stuff, but this is a, just in case you don't have Eurorack and you still want to be able to control all the functionality of your Subharmonicon. So VCO frequency 1 is MIDI CC 4, which here I have set to the first knob. VCO sub-frequency, sub-1 frequency, that's this knob, is MIDI CC 103, and that's here. MIDI VCO 1 sub-2 is MIDI CC 104, and that's here. And likewise, in the same fashion, I have VCO 2. VCO 2 is MIDI CC 12, sub-1 105, sub-2 106. For these two knobs, I have it set to the attack stage of the filter and amplifier, respectively, filter, amplifier. That's the way it made the most sense to me, to have the oscillators up top here, VCO1, VCO2, sub1, sub1, sub2, sub2, and the attack phase of both of the envelopes. You might want to do something different. It's really all up to you. But the fun thing about that is that you can then program your knob movements, which makes it a heck of a lot easier to really perform with the Subharmonicon instead of blindly stabbing at different pitches and coming across something, maybe sampling something. You can actually program really intelligent chords with it. So let me give you a small example of that. We'll just start with the basic rhythm for sequencer 1 and sequencer 2, not divided by anything, and all the pitches are at 0. Right now we're just listening to oscillator 1. So I'll set some pitches here. We'll divide that down a little bit. Bring in oscillator 2. divide that down a little bit. All right, now that's sounding pretty fun. We've got a decent little sequence happening there. Let's open up the decay stage a little bit. So now with the electron, I'm going to go through the different parameter changes that you can make and sequence. That's pretty good. So I will make a very quick adjustment here by one thing to note on the Digitone that I kind of discovered is that this roll is the piano roll, and if you go into here and just drop some trigs in, like in any electron machine, that will actually trigger notes, if you can see that, which you probably can't. What you want to do on these machines is hold the funk button and hit the trig, which turns it yellow, which basically means you're not adding a note, you're just adjusting the particular value of that. Otherwise, what you're going to do is play the subharmonicon like a keyboard, which can also be very cool. We'll maybe get into that in a different video. But for now, what we're going to do is just program in some changes to the MIDI controllers. Thank you. then just like that, you can create something pretty complex. This was only a one bar phrase at 16th notes on the Digitone, but you can see here that you can create something very, very, very complex with sequencing your subharmonicon, especially with something like the Digitone, which allows for parameter locks. If you're using something like Ableton Live or any of the suitable DAWs, they have extensive MIDI control, and you can do very, very deep things with that. That being said, thanks again for watching, guys, and like I said, if you like this video, hit the subscribe and like button, and we'll see you next time. Peace.